Now I chose 80 stitches because when you divide 80 by 8, you get 10. I'm going to have 8 decreases on the top of this hat. If I had 60 stitches, I would divide it by 6. Again, you get 10, but that one would have 6 decreases on the top. It really all depends on how many decreases you want. Most hand knit patterns, I think, have 6 decreases for the crown. So what I need to do here is I have to move the 9th stitch to the 10th needle. So if I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, I'm only bringing it out a little, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, because I'm doing half of this, I'm going to do the knitter first, then I'll do the ribber second. Now, I have one stitch on the end over here, so I want to move the knitter stitches to the left. But what I'm going to do is take that one stitch, just move it in for now, because I do need to transfer these stitches inwards so there's no empty needles. See, I have 1, 2, 3, and there would have been 4 there. So what I'm going to do is, I've got 1, 2, 3. I'm going to take this one here on the left, and I'm going to move these stitches inwards. And I am pulling the needles out to hold position. Oops. Only so I do not drop a stitch. I'll try not to, but I've done it in the past. But now I got to come over here. I could start here and move over, but I'm going to have 2 stitches or 2 needles empty right there, and it really stretches out the yarn. So I'm just going to go ahead and move the outside stitches inwards. And yeah, I will have to do it again because I have to start here. To move these other stitches inwards. But this gives you a really nice crown to the top of the hat. So there's no needles out in work position. I am going to knit across. But now I need to do the ribber. And as you see, I'm offset here. But because I worked that way, now I need to start on this one. So I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So again, well, because I moved the knitter to the left, now I need to move these stitches to the right. But because there's one stitch there that I have to transfer over, so you want to pay attention to what you're doing. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be transferring the stitches towards the carriage. So when I have the knitter, I have the carriage over here. That means I'm going to move those stitches to the left and then these to the right. But then I need to, again, move those in, 1, 2, 3, so the 4th one was already done. I am going to start here again, and I only have to move these one section inwards. I do not have to have these on certain needles. It really doesn't matter. All that matters is that I line them up And, oop, you don't want to put the yarn around the gate peg. And then I'm going to go over here and move these in. And I got to be careful, the yarn is splitting on me. This, I think it's Pound of Love. It does split very easily. And then I have to come over here. And I really do not want to drop stitches while I'm working on the double bed. It's really hard, especially decreasing. Although I notice I'm off a little bit here. I could use my racking indicator to get this back on track, but I'll only be able to do that, four times? Let's see. If it's going to go like that. I only got two more times to do that. So I have to pay attention to where I am putting these stitches. Or I'm going to have to move them all over. Okay, so now I knit back. I want to make sure. Give them a little tug on the material underneath. Now, in a hand knit pattern, you will decrease one row, knit one row around. Then you will decrease again. So I need to knit one more round here. And this time, I am going to move the 8th stitch to the 9th needle. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Bring it out just a little bit in case I'm off or I miscounted. 8, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and now see, I'm off. That's why I like to just pull them out in case I have to move them back. So, 8th stitch on the 9th needle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So it worked out this time. So again, I am going to move these stitches to the left. But I think what I have to do is I have to move all the stitches over to the left to close it in. That way I don't have to keep moving my racking, keep racking the machine so that it does line up all the time. So basically you're just going to have to pay attention or maybe mark down on a paper what stitches you're decreasing, do the knitter, or unless you're going... Let's see, I'm going clockwise, so if you're going counterclockwise, you would do the ribber first, decrease, move the stitches in, knit across, decrease on the knitter, move the stitches in, knit across, and then one whole round. So it all depends on which way you have your carriages set up. So I'm going to keep going down until I have probably 8 stitches. 16 is a little bit too much, so I'm going to go down to the 8 stitches, and then I will gather bind off, and then take it off the machine. So I cut a little tail at the end, don't really need an awful lot. I took the hanger and weight off of the back part of this. I left it on the front, and I want to, one by one, well, I guess it's best to go on the needle and push it back and get it off, get the stitch off of that needle. You want to be careful with the gate pegs. So I'm going to bring the other four needles up, remove the hanger and the weight on that one, and then I am going to, probably be best if I even drop my ribber bed a bit, take off these last four stitches. But what I'm going to do is put the hat in my lap so it doesn't fall down. Well, let's see if it went through that last one. Yeah, it did. I could go and fix any stray yarns that got pulled out on this. Everything looks good. Now I need to remove the waste yarn here. And then also I am going to take and cinch the top of both hats. But I got to get my needle back out again. And then tie a little knot in there. But I want to see, okay, so I have the waste yarn here. Because I didn't use ravel cord, I may have to just undo one by one the waste yarn. Oh, I guess it goes that way. Maybe not. I could probably even clip the yarn, the waste yarn, here and there, making sure it's just the waste yarn, and eventually pull out the last row here of the waste yarn, or the first row, really. Oh! I think that went the wrong way. So, yeah, that kind of went the wrong way. But let me work at this, and you're going to take your waste yarn off if you had not already. You are going to secure the top of each hat, and then you're going to push the one, which this one's going to be the inside. It's a little bit thinner yarn than this. I'm going to push that up inside, the light green one. And there you go. Now, the good thing with this one, it is definitely reversible. And of course, if you wanted to, you could change a little bit in the middle here so that it's all the same color. You would have to do, oh, so many rows of the other color is all to make it match up. But I like it this way. Now, if you put a pom-pom on here, or a bebop as somebody calls them, I would make the pom-pom, sew a snap to it, and then put a snap both on both sides. It's really not going to hurt the person's head. Get a small snap, maybe. And that way there, and I would use both yarns, that way there, you're going to make a hat that's reversible and have that pom-pom with both colors in there.